So tonight we're going to do a natural edge mushroom. There are a couple different kinds you can do. You can either do, I've done a few different variations. Most of these are based off of Worth the Effort. He's on YouTube. He does a lot of, you know, he's a teacher, so he does a really good, you know, lesson on really explaining things. He does two different types. He does the palm tree style here with the natural edge base, and then he also does the, I believe he calls it like an onion shape without the base. You can do it with the base, but it's a lot harder to sand down inside of this groove, whereas on all these other ones, it's really easy to get at, really easy to sand, so that's why I'm assuming he doesn't generally put the live edge on the bottom as well. Because with this one, you can get real easy up in there. This one, you just take it off. With these, what you're ideally looking for is, I mean, in theory, obviously it's just a branch. You're wanting a branch all the way around, 3, 4, 5 inches round, just all varying sizes. You know, this one. What you really look for is the key things or anything that has like accent, like any like branches, any cross sections, anything that you can just kind of take advantage of, you know, just making the top look oblong. None of these are, you know, round. If you look, you can kind of put them a little off center and give them a little bit of a different shape to them. These ones, obviously, you guys don't need to see me put a tenon on a round thing. You just put it between centers. That's going to be the only, I guess, bit of advice I give you. You don't want to drive the top center in too far. You're going to turn a lot off. Otherwise, you're going to, this compresses a lot of those fibers in. And I've learned is as you turn it, if you don't turn enough off and you start sanding, you'll still have that dimple underneath even the turned off part. So you got to really take it, you know, quite a bit in from turning it between centers. The bottom one, obviously, you'll turn it off and it won't matter. So I always start, honestly, generally, this one, I didn't square up the end on the bandsaw, so I have the tailstock up here. Every other one I've done so far has never had tailstock. I don't usually use it. You round the top and then undercut the underside. So we're going to go ahead and leave this up here for a second until I get that straightened away. And it's nothing what I'm used to. Take that away, let's tighten the check down. That's one thing I give you advice on. Any greenwood, always tighten the check every chance you get. Stop it, just because you never know that greenwood compresses. You see how much I just did it there. Backwards for my lid. And I'm again making sure I'm going deep enough so I can get rid of that groove so I don't have to a couple of these, if you look real careful, they got fat spots on the top of it. Had to just sand until you just can't sand anymore. Until that dimple's gone. I still have a feeling it's there, so we're going to go real harder. Once you get the rough shape down, that's pretty much where I'll sand this, and then I'll come back and do the inside. So, and of course, I don't have to drill set up. I think I may still have some of that center, but we're going to go ahead and leave it for the sake of this argument. So. One thing I will say, the more drastic you get on the angle, it's going to be way harder to get up and under the cap. And that's where the hardest part of this entire thing comes in, is getting this angle up and under here. And then if this cap isn't perfectly round, you have to hit it from behind and catch up to that, I don't know if it makes sense, the part that isn't all the way out here on the edge. To get this thin line all the way around, the top has to be consistent all the way up under there, almost all the way up to the stem itself. And that's where the trick comes in. And all these are turning green, so if you don't get it perfectly thick all the way through, it'll definitely have more of a tendency to crack on you. So that's a big key. Thank you. and I don't know how clear it is. You kind of see what I'm talking about here, how thick it is here versus how thin it kind of is on the edges here. So in order to get this thickness here, I'm going to have to come up and behind this other cap to not touch the outside of the farthest out part. I kind of got to come in at an angle and catch it behind the other, you know, the outside part. Then to save your knuckles, best advice I can give is you're not going to try and keep that bottom edge, take as much of this bark up early as you can, because it'll grab your knuckles and it hurts. And I always work my leg kind of down. I don't worry about the bottom half other than getting the bark off until I have the cap really thin. You want as much stability up through the body as you can. You also have to give yourself enough here, so you got to work your way back a little bit. It's gotten a little thinner here, almost matches a little more consistently around. It's still a little too thick for my liking, but this is thinned out a little since I've come back in and taken it out underneath. So it's a lot of stop and check. Some woods too, now when I'm looking at it, some woods aren't very good for live edge because it starts to flake off if you get too thin. This is going to be one of those ones. It looks like I'm losing a few pieces here and there. So again, also I had one I did really drastic the other day that kind of made the bark look like icicles, but they were barely hanging on to any little, you know, grab of the tool, it was gone. Thank you. It's like a special scraper that we kind of designed to come back in and under the cap. It doesn't 100%, it's almost 2% of these smaller ones because it has the cutting sides on both sides, so if you don't watch both sides, you catch that other side, it's definitely going to give you some trouble. So I'll show you here, yeah. So on the underside of these caps, it's really hard to get your tool marks out because sometimes it's hitting wood, sometimes it's catching air, so you'll get a lot of grooves, but thankfully mushrooms are pretty, you know, oddball, so you can kind of, anything goes with mushrooms. And there you go. And the problem is this one is sticking out so far over this tool rest, that's why I'm getting a lot of And that's actually pretty decent for underneath the cap there. So what I'll do is come back, work on the stem, and then sand everything on the underside. And then it either, yeah, get some friction polish, or you can, like I said, these, all I do is just let them sit around and Danish oil them, and they kind of slowly have done what they needed to do without cracking. Only had one crack, and I've had apple crack real bad on me before. That's when I got up here. I left in the truck today, too. It's really hot out, so. Like I said, underneath the edge is definitely the trickiest part. That's it. Super simple. Probably a little thicker than I'd usually build out here in the stone, but I was getting a lot of trailer on this little guy. I'm used to quite a bit larger layers, so I'm trying to adapt here. So let's just take a little chisel off the bottom, sand off the bottom. A little bit of mess underneath of there, but for the most part, that's the, like I said, that's the palm tree in a thicker version than I'd usually go on some of these. So, no clock, so I can't see what time it is.
Looks good.
You want to try and knock out the onion just so we show the onion shaped part? So does everybody want to see me do the other one too? That sure doesn't sound reassuring. I was a little nervous on this one. Everybody's nervous on the second one, so. I almost made my tendon too small. You might not see this one.
What are you saying? I shouldn't sit here?
You were brave enough for the first one, so. No, it looks like I said there was. She disappeared. She was sitting right here. She disappeared on me. Might answer this one. I'm just going to bring this up for safety sakes again. I shouldn't even worry about the top. pushing the lead. It might still center, but this thing kept it was moving on me, so. Then maybe it wasn't moving that much on me, I thought it was. For the sake of this one, I'm not going to stand on top. I'm going to leave the center on there because this one's a lot longer than the other one. A lot more torque on this than the last one was. So this was my backup blank. I wasn't sure if that first one was going to make it all the way through, so I made sure I had two. Just cleared up this afternoon.
Yeah.
I mean, well, this one was too. So this is the other part of this one. All of these so far have been the same. Like, I don't know. Back here. See if I'd lost a big chunk of this one.
No, I
haven't gotten around to that yet today. But I wanted to turn something and knew I could turn this dog out. But this one's going to be a challenge.
It looks about like it's same color.
No, I haven't gotten a chance yet. Almost perfect example right here of how thin it can get on one spot and then how thick I still have to undercut this whole section right there. But I'm going to come back and redo the top.
$100 coming off of this one. We're gonna go ahead and just call it real. Still could probably be done under the thing, but for time's sake, I'm just gonna show the other body now. The top's exactly the same under the cap, underneath all that. Really, the only difference is the body and just the shape. And it can be any shape your heart desires, as long as the bottom's attached to the top, I guess. There really isn't any definitive muscle shape. Pretty much the general idea of the onion body, and there's part of it underneath, and I just usually hand sand the bottom. Like I said, this is where, like I said, if you want to try and leave the natural edge, this is where the extra effort will come in, is trying to get down in between. This one I left enough room, but on ones like this where you kind of really taper it in, it's almost impossible. I mean, without having just scratch marks all over, trying to, since it's a spindle tendon and the way the grain's running, it's just kind of a pain. Maybe it's just me being a beginner. I don't know. There may be tricks that I don't know yet, but that's the gist of it. Really simple project. That's the idea. Crank them out in 20, 30 minutes. That's the idea, is get them done and get them out the door. Craft fair projects. That's kind of where my mind's been lately. So that's where, you know, super simple. You can sand out any mistakes there are. You use branches that normally you don't get to use. So that was one of those, you know, one of these few projects that just kind of quick, easy, you know, you don't wait, you know, kind of sneak in around your bowls. You don't have to do just all bowls. Like I said, unique wood comes in branches sometimes. We start with Terry Iler's little bowls that you can do some amazing stuff with some little things.
So, any questions? It's pretty straightforward. Top and a bottom, stem and a cap. That's about all there is to it. So,
looks good.
Well, not this one. This one's a little better. No, that's definitely a, and like I said, this was, you know, a little more rough, so obviously these all have been, you know, sanded quite a bit. So I've gotten my fair share of sanding in on these, learned a lot. I'm, again, not used to this little lathe, so it was a bit of an adjustment curve. So hopefully somebody learned something. I don't know beyond that. This will be my first time. Thank you all for being my first. So.